Hi students, I am Pawan, your science master. Today I would like to speak to 6th standard students. Students, we have been talking about third lesson, rain, where does it come from, and we have been talking about various sub concepts related to this chapter. And I want you to recollect the concept, that sub concept that we talked in the previous class. What we have talked in the previous class? Yes, we have talked about clothes in kitchen, right? Clothes in kitchen. Here in this video, what I would like to teach you is, so far we understood rain, where does it come from, but how does it come? That let us see now. See students, due to the movement of earth, you know what is this direction? This is south, this is north, and then this is east and this is west. Okay, generally we get rains in particular season, particular season, that season we call rainy season. We call that season as rainy season. Especially in rainy season, do we get rains in all the days? No, right? And around 3 or 4 months of the season, do we get all the months? Do we get rains during all of these 3 or 4 months? No, right? But we get rains only during some months, like, you know, we get June to September. Between June to September, and also we get rains during November and December. Okay, and also we get rains between these months, November and December. So here actually a natural process takes place, that movement of winds. Okay, what's that movement of winds? See students, during June to September, the winds move from south to west. Okay, south to west during June to September. I'm just writing only letter here, try to understand. During these months, the winds move from south to west. So when the winds move from this season, from this direction to that direction, the rains occur in this season are called southwest monsoon. What? South west monsoon. Okay, the rains we get in this season, in these months, June to September, the winds, the rains we get in these months, during these months, because the winds move from south direction to west direction, so that we get rains due to the movement of winds from this direction to that, south direction to west direction, we call that as southwest monsoon. Okay, southwest monsoon takes place in which months? June to September. Okay, and next, what about November to December? Yeah, on the whole we can understand here the rains occur due to the movement of winds. Okay, and here about if you think about the movement of winds in this season, you know, in these months November and December, the winds move from north to east. Okay, the winds move from north to east. Students, the rains occur in these months as well. Okay, sometimes we get rains during these months also. So the rains that we get during these months due to the movement of wind from north to east is called northeast monsoon. Northeast monsoon. So you can say the monsoon is the rainy season is in two parts. One is what? Southwest and northeast. Southwest monsoon and northeast monsoon. Okay, students, like this you can understand how the rains occur. Okay, yeah, students, I want you to understand another thing, that we get rains only because of the evaporation and condensation, and to happen all these processes in a proper order, there should be a balanced conditions in the nature. Balanced conditions in the sense, so there should be a proper life processes like photosynthesis, and there should be proper proportions of the gases in the air like carbon dioxide, nitrogen and oxygen and all the things should be in proper proportions in the air. And to maintain all these gases in the air in proper proportions, we should not cut the trees. And if we cut the trees, there what happens? There the photosynthesis process will not take place proper. And what is photosynthesis? You don't know, right? Is this new term to you, photosynthesis? And what is photosynthesis and all, you will learn in your higher classes. And you just remember, photosynthesis is the life process takes place in the plants. If that process takes place, only the gases in the atmosphere, in the air, will be in a proper proportion. So when all the things are in balanced manner, then only we get proper rains. Okay, students, so if we go on cutting the trees, what happens? The gases present in the air will get disturbed. Okay, the amount of the gases present in the air will get disturbed, and then there will not be a proper proportions of the gases in the air. So what should not we do? We should not cut the trees. Cutting down of the trees also affect the rainfall. Okay, cutting down of the trees also affect the rainfall. So what is the lesson name actually? The lesson is, rain, where does it come from? How do the plants affect the rainfall? How do the plants affect the rainfall? Plants maintain the atmosphere gases. Okay, students, plants maintain the atmospheric gases like carbon dioxide, oxygen, nitrogen and methane and other inert gases, other inert gas. These are all the gases, and etc. etc. So many gases present in the air, right? All of these gases should be in proper, what? Proper proportions. Proper proportions in the sense, the ratio of the gases, the air in the atmosphere should be with a limited amount of these gases. If any one of these gases is more or less, then ultimately life on the earth is affected, and the natural processes like rainfall and the temperature in the atmosphere will also be affected. If there are less number of plants, what happens? If there are what? Plants actually take what? Carbon dioxide. Plants actually take carbon dioxide and give oxygen. So, in the process, plants are main things that are playing role in taking carbon dioxide and giving oxygen. Okay? If we cut down the plants, cutting of trees is called as cutting of trees is called as deforestation. Students, deforestation. Remember, what is deforestation? Why is it happened? Due to cutting down of the trees. Okay? Deforestation is because of cutting down of the trees. If we go on cutting the trees, that process, cutting down of the trees, is called deforestation. In the process of deforestation, what happens? If there are less number of trees, the amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere will be increased. If there are less number of trees, the amount of carbon dioxide will be increased in the atmosphere. The more amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere increases the increasing the temperature. Okay? Increasing the temperature. And due to increased temperature, more amount of evaporation, you know, evaporation, more rate of evaporation. More temperature, more evaporation, because more temperature, the water bodies will get evaporated more and more. And then, if more evaporation, there may be, you know, more or less rains. Okay, rainfall will not be normal. Okay, like this, we are affected. Ultimately, we are affected. Okay, students, this is how the rains, deforestation affects our lifestyle. Okay, there may happen floods due to increased gases or decreased gases of the atmosphere. And so, there may happen more or less rains. If less rains, there may be scarcity of food, scarcity of water, etc. And if there are more rains and there may be floods, there may be, you know, migration from one place to another, and we are maybe affected by the floods. Okay, so that keeping all these things in our mind, we have to maintain the nature. So each one of you plant one plant. Okay, so a seed, so a plant. Okay, I hope you all understood this chapter, and this is for today, students. Thank you for listening. Thank you one and all. And moreover, I wanted to give you a questionnaire in the description box. You click on the link and you will get a question paper. You answer to that questions, and each right answer gives you 1 point. Okay, thank you, students, and I hope you all do this. Thank you.